young people serving the Lord. If I say it's good to be here, you will say it's wonderful to be here. And if I say it's wonderful to be here, you'll say it's good to be here. Okay? It's good to be here.
It's wonderful to be here.
It's good to be here.
It's wonderful to be here.
It's wonderful to be here.
It's good to be here.
Yes, brothers and sisters. It's good and wonderful to be here. Every time I am invited to preach here, I find it privilege, and it's a blessing. Just this morning, when I woke up, there were three messages. There were three messages in my cell phone. And the third time I was able to pass the one who was calling me, that was Pastor Neil. The other Sabbath, I preached at the West Park Church. And they introduced me as Pastor Neil. And when they asked me again, I learned to preach. And who is going to preach today? It's Pastor Neil, in the person of Pastor Sam. Yeah. And somebody asked me, it's been a long time that we didn't see you. Where have you been? Well, we were running around. Just like Satan in the book of Job. But anyway, it's a good thing. I accepted the call to help the Steinmark Church. Not church yet. Steinmark Ministry. And the conference hired me to be part-time table worker at Steinmark. And interesting enough that I accepted the call, but never went to Steinmark. And so, when I went to Steinbeck for the first time, oh my, if I had only knew how challenging it was, I should have said no. But since I said yes before I went, I had no choice. So, Steinbeck is a very wonderful place, and we have wonderful people who are working over there right now. They told me that when they were trying to establish the church at the time, it was initiated by the conference, because they think and they believe that Steinbach, this is the right time to start a new church at the time, because Steinbach is the third largest city in Manitoba, if I'm not mistaken. According to statistics, they have more than 13,000 people at this time back. And if you go to Steinbach, it's a beautiful city. It's booming. They said the economy is booming. You can see buildings like mushrooms. And immigrants are coming in. And so Steinbach is a very interesting place. Another thing is, they told me that Steinbach is one of the most religious places in Manitoba. Because if you go to Steinbach...
Yeah, that's not a bit. Are you saying that? Let's put on the record that it is said that Steinbach is the Bible Belt of Canada.
Yeah, it is. It's not only Manitoba, it's Canada. Wow. So it's really interesting that if you go to Steinbach, imagine that you are in a certain block. So the next block, you will see again, you will see a big church again. Go to another block, there's another church again. And if you walk farther, there will be another church again. Huge churches and beautiful churches. And according to the internet and the source, they have already around 26 churches at the same time. Big churches. Very interesting, right? And when I went there, thinking that I was alone in my car. I was praying, Lord, I don't know what to do. And well, I just go there and see. So I went to thank God. And I went in the morning. The first time, whom do you think I'm going to target first? The Indians. So I went there. I went to Superstore because they have Superstore. They have Walmart. They have Tim Hortons. They have also a lot of things. Name it. It's really a city. And so I went to Walmart, no Filipino. I went to the Superstore, there was one Filipino, a worker, and then, oh my, there's no Filipino. And then I tried to stay in the corner in the street. There are only few people. There are only few cars and trucks. What is this? What town is this? It's very quiet. And so I was praying, and the Lord brought me to Filipino store, and that's the exact Filipino store. And I had a chance to sit down there, and they welcomed me. And I talked to the owner, and we had a good conversation. And they gave me some of the names that I need to contact. They made mention about Melanie Parada, and they told me that she is a Ilocana. Ilocana is my dialect, actually. And they, interesting enough that Melanie Parada comes from our own place, San Mateo, that is where my hometown, and she comes from San Mateo. And, now I have a problem, but I haven't met this lady. And they told me that she is the manager of the Highlight Barn. And they made mention of some names like Wadi, some of those people. And they, they told me that there's again another store, a Filipino store, so I went to another store, and I had some contacts with the Filipinos, and now the ball is rolling. I'm becoming more excited. And then I went home to pray for these people. The next time around, I brought my wife to have a climax. And this time, we stayed in that store again. While having a conversation with the people there, a man came in, and he introduced his name. Of course, we introduced ourselves, and he introduced his name. His name is Jason. And he said, I'm Jason Faraha. Wow, Jason Faraha. I asked him, how are you related with Melanie? And he said, she's my wife. And so I asked him, should we visit you in your house? And he said, yes, come in our house on this day. So, the next time we went to their house, we stayed there, that was last Saturday, last Friday. We stayed in their house until around 10 o'clock in the evening. Interestingly enough, that she in we met Melanie, and they invited us well. They invited the brother with Brother Bo. When they went, they told me about a name. And the name is Noel Acosta. Noel Acosta. And I said, I prayed for this guy, Noel Paraka, Noel Acosta. And all of a sudden, Noel Acosta came in being introduced to us together with the wife and another family, and they came, and we had a really good conversation. They said, can you stay for a dinner? We said, yes, we will stay for the dinner, and they cooked food for us, and they even gave us food to bring home. And we were very happy, and they invited us again. They said, come Saturday next week, we are going to have house blessing. So this afternoon, we are going to attend the house blessing. And another thing is,
Brother Dave. He gave me the name of the Michael Swartstra. I don't know how to pronounce it. What's the last name? He is the counselor. He's one of the counselors of Simon. And they told me that he is a Seventh Adventist by, I don't know, in Saskatchewan. But when we moved to Steinbach, he opted not to become a Seventh Adventist anymore. And he attended the biggest church in Steinbach, which is the Southland Church. And now he is actively participating in Southland Church. So I phoned him one morning. He was very excited to answer me, and I told him, I heard that you mentioned during your first meeting with the Seventh-day Adventist that you are willing to help this group. And he said, yes. Would you be willing to extend your help now that we are going to focus on having some problems in your place? He said, yes. And I told him, can we have a special meeting with you? He said, yes. Can I bring my team with me when I come? He said, yes. And so I had a good meeting last Sunday with his health expert at West Park. Then I told him last Monday and informed him, I'm happy that we are going to meet you. When are you going to be available? And he said, I don't know. And I told him, would you be willing to accommodate us on the 4th of Saturday, the 4th of December? And said, yes. As you know, we don't have a place at this time. And he said, and I asked him further, would you be willing to accommodate us in your house? And he said, yes, come to my house. What time? And he said, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I said, well said, thank you very much. We'll go to your house and meet with you. And we are going to discuss how we could help this time. The Lord is opening doors. Now, my dear friends, why I'm telling this? I'm excited that God is opening doors at this time. Now, what is our responsibility? Some of you will go there. But some of you, many of you, do not go to Steinbach. We need your prayer. And those people who made the commitment to help Steinbach, this will be the time to rally together with us, and we are going to help Steinbach. And if you have some people, acquaintances in Steinbach, please let them know that we have the presence there. And let us know your acquaintances at Steinbach, and we are going to meet them. And in that way, a church, a lighthouse at Steinbach will be established there. So we need your prayers. I really need your prayers, because sometimes when I go alone, if you are alone, sometimes there are negative things. And I'm thinking, Lord, can you please send somebody to go with us, something like that. But anyway, we need your prayers. Can you pray for us?
Yes.
Can you pray for us?
Yes.
Amen. Now let's pray for the lesson. Shall we pray? Oh, my Father, we are excited now to receive your words. We pray that you please open our hearts now and cover me with the blood of Jesus. Our lesson for this morning is very simple. Amen. For calm. May you please, oh God, speak to us now. In Jesus' name.
Okay.
But the text of last night is very familiar to each one of us. It's the golden rule. You know the golden rule? Do unto others what you want them to you. Do not do unto others the things that you do not want them do to you. Is that right? Okay. The title is Take Off That. We are going to read this story. A father and his little son were walking through a valley when suddenly the boy tripped and fell. Feeling a sharp pain, the boy shouted out instinctively, "Ah!" Almost immediately came an echo
of this scream from one side of the mountain. Ah! Oh, ah! Oh. Have you ever experienced that? If you go to a mountain, you are going to shop, you can hear the echo. And almost immediately again, the echo of this scream from one side of the mountain. Ah! Oh, ah! Oh. The little boy was surprised from hearing this, as it was the first time that he had heard his own echo. Have you ever had experience that when you had first shouted at the mountain and there was somebody who was trying to copy your voice? That's an echo. Almost immediately came an echo of his voice. And the little boy was surprised on hearing this, as it was the first time that he had heard his own voice. Filled with curiosity, he shouted back, "Who are you? Who are you?" Only to receive the same echo, "Who are you?" Thinking that someone was mocking him, he became angry and shouted, "You are crazy, Bill! You are crazy, Bill!" And the echo came back to him with a similar reply. Of course, if this is your first time, you will be annoyed. That annoyed him greatly, and he angrily shouted, "You stupid girl! You stupid girl!" Only to find the same insult hurled back at him. He then looked at his father and asked, "Daddy, who's that on the other side? Why is he rude to me?" Here in Canada, sometimes you hear the word rude, and my daughter said, he is very rude. You hear that with the young people? He's very rude. Here, his reply is very small. Oh, no. Sometimes people are rude. Sometimes I'm rude too. Are you sometimes rude? Yes, sometimes. Unmindfully, sometimes we are rude. Even if we don't speak, sometimes we say, action speaks louder than words. Right? Or maybe we are not rude in the way we speak, but the way we act is rude. Sometimes it's deeper. It differs the way how we say it. Like me, myself, personally, my tribe in the Philippines, I belong to, though we are Ilocanos from the north, but Ilocanos has different segments, or so to say, tribes among Ilocanos. And I belong to the Bacaras. Bacara people comes from the province, from the town of Bacara in Ilocos Norte, which when they speak, as if they are angry all the time. We hear these people that every day, how they speak, the way they want to convey smoothly, but the way they speak is still very strong. That is my tribe in the Philippines. And luckily, I went to the south, and the way I speak is a little bit softened, so to say. His father said, "Son," he started replied, "I want you to pay attention and listen carefully to what I'm doing." Now the father demonstrated to the son. Upon saying that, he shouted, "I love you! I love you!" Oh, there's an echo. And an echo answered with the same, "I love you." The father then shouted, "You are wonderful! You are wonderful!" And the echo returned the same compliment. The thoroughly confused boy was very surprised by all this and wondered to himself why the person on the other side was so nice to my father, but not, of course, not to him. He was wondering. Then his father explained, "Think people call this echo, but actually, this is life. Echo is life. You see, life is always. Life always gives you back, but you give up. Life is like a mirror of your actions." Try to stand at the front of the church, that whoever comes, you smile. What will happen?
He smiles back.
Then how about if you are friendly? What will happen? Of course, you will become friendly. But I had an experience, very interesting. I was in Jerusalem. It was Sabbath morning. And as my practice, every morning, coming from my employer, I stayed in during the night, and I walked from the apartment to the church. The Jews, it is their practice to recite that they do not ride a car, they just walk. Interestingly enough, that on the road going to the church, especially in Jerusalem, because this is the place where you can see the Orthodox Jews, so to say. They are ultra religious Jews. They wear black, just like me, black shoes, black pants, black suits, and white, and with the combination of black scarf. There were chances when we met on the road. I smiled, but they never smiled back. Interesting. Just like during the time of Jesus, as if nobody in the room. Have you ever experienced that, brother? You smile and they never smile back. Maybe they have a problem. Or the other way around, you smile, they smile at you, and you never smile. It happens as well. But the thing is, most of the time, if you smile, they will smile back. If you are friendly, they will be friendly at you. It happens. In our apartment, I'm happy with my wife because there are Filipinos around, and there are blessings that come to us. It is our practice in the Philippines that if you receive something, you are going to share it with the other Filipinos. And in the Philippines as well, when I was a little boy, I remember that when my mother cooked special food, we share it to our neighbors. Our neighbors, my mother make it sure that all the neighbors will receive food. And at the time when they have special food, they will give also some portion to us. And in the apartment, I saw my wife giving food to the neighbors, the Filipino neighbors. Now, interesting that when they had some fresh eggs, they give us also a box of eggs. Interesting. It's free. What you give, you will receive. So if you give a smile, what will happen? Smile back. And another thing, if you are going to pay attention to this chapter, chapter 7 of Matthew, if you pay attention in verse 18, you will see, verse 15 and 16 and 17, you will notice that it says there that by their fruits you shall know them. And it talks about the false prophets. Who are the false prophets? You shall know them by their fruits. How about a true Seventh-day Adventist? You will know them by their fruits. Now we'll go back to the story. If you want love, give it to others. If you want kindness, patience, give the same to others. If you want to be respected, respect others. If you want people to be considerate, do likewise. Interesting that in the interview, I had the chance to be interviewed in the addiction program at the Main Street Project. You know what's Main Street Project? Main Street Project is a company here in Winnipeg that deals with those who are addicted with drugs. They are drug dependents. And one of the questions is, how do you show? It talks about how do you respect your superiors. And I was telling them that respect is really something that we need to have, because if you respect,
they will also respect him. Second Adventist people, these traits are missing. Agree? The young people, it's not different. Sometimes these traits are missing. They call it, I was talking to Pastor Neil and said, you know, these young people these days are different now from the young people before. No, because they are now missing this word respect to their parents. To the Filipinos, you can see, if they pay respect, these little children, they usually pay respect to their parents. They ask the hands of the elderly and put it on their head. You oftentimes see this to those new immigrants, Filipinos. But these days, the young people, they are missing this respect. Even the way they speak, they are now missing, they are now losing this way, this respect to the elderly. And of course, the Bible says that in the last days, they will lose these things. Now, that would be the sign that he is really coming. But in here, if you want to be respected, respect others. If you want people to be considerate, do likewise. This rule of nature applies to every aspect of our lives, because life always gives you back what you give. What happens in your life is not a string of coincidences, but a mirror of your own actions and doings. And upon hearing that explanation, the boy shouted, "You are a nice person!" What is the reply? "You are a nice person." He was delighted when the echo said the same to him. The happy little boy then cried something anew. "I want to be your friend! I want to be your friend!" The echo responded similarly. He learned that day that he could very much determine whether his life was going to be happy, one or unhappy one, by his choice of action to others. This rule of life commonly referred to as the golden rule, being taught by Jesus when he was here in this world. This message is for everybody. This message is for you and for me. This message is for the non-Adventists and to the Adventists as well, those who are waiting for the second coming of Jesus, as it says in Matthew 7:12. "Therefore, whatsoever you want men to do to you, do also to them. When this rule is practiced by all men, our world will definitely be one that is filled with sweetness and peace, for this is the desire of all men." May the Lord bless us this morning. Okay, this is the